Today, when I look at it again after a long time since last time, the items have changed completely. There was an update called, so I would like to introduce you to the Kohya LoRA training tutorial. But I will set it up like this. Speaking of Mazaura, if you look at the previous video and ask if it has changed completely, about 70% has been inherited. So I don't think you can understand it by looking at it. Take a look at it all. So I will put this page on GitHub in the video description column. There is this Kohya LoRA Dreambooth, where I went down a little. Click open in Colab on this link to get started. Copy to drive. After doing so, we will execute one by one from the top. So this is a Google Drive mount drive. Check the box and run to allow connection to the drive. I think you can do it with a free Colab account. It's about 1000 yen per month, so it's more comfortable to have a paid subscription. We recommend that you enter a paid account, so you don't have to worry about when your GPU will run out. Yes, done. A green check will appear here when completed. So I feel like it took quite a while. Then you can see that Google Drive is mounted here. And then skip this. What to learn in the next model download. Recommended is stable Diffusion 1.5. People who want to use the 2.0 series should select 2.0 here and do not select anything here. My recommendation is 1.5. Stable Diffusion 1.5 is recommended. Regardless of whether you are doing animation or live action, if you want to download it yourself, bring a URL such as a hanging face here. Paste the token and execute. Please do this, or do it yourself on Google Drive. You can also put the model in advance. Having said that, I still think Stable Diffusion 1.5 is good. It's a download option for the next VAE. I download Stable Diffusion's VAE. Next, this is the default directory for outputting training data. No need to mess with it. Put the path of the zip file containing the training data here, because it is an unzipped dataset. I have prepared a zip file in this my drive in advance. So paste the path like this and execute. Automatically enter the appropriate place. Leave this unzipped to blank. So what's inside the zip? Well, anyway, any number of images of what you want to learn is fine. I have prepared about 8. It is supposed to put it in a folder and zip it. In particular, it's not good to make the image size too small. It will automatically trim it, so you don't have to think about it. Just prepare an image that looks good and zip it. So, as I always say, if you're a person, you can't do the same pose. The same background is not allowed. Don't wear the same clothes. The same hairstyle is useless. If the background is the same, it will be recognized as the person, including the background. So if you want to learn the person, separate them all. Well, please prepare 8 or 10 sheets and put them in. I think 8 is enough. This is to automatically bring the image from the anime site. I won't do this. I'll bring some extra images, so I have to use this. This is checked and run. This is to delete when extra things are included in the zip file. I think it's fine because I prepared it myself. Please run. This is when the prepared image is PNG and the background is transparent. At times like that, it becomes a strange learning experience. It is an item that automatically adds color to the background transparency. If you prepare in PNG and do not have a background, please check this. This essentially adds captions automatically. A number that is divisible by the data that you have learned by this batch size. I'm 8, so I'm learning 8, so 8 is fine. If you have learned 10 cards, please leave this as 5 or something. Same below. This badge is the same. So in execution, this 4.2.2 needs to be fiddled with here. Besides the batch size, like this. But people and objects. Tokyo Tower and Ryogoku Kokujiken. The person who teaches that sort of thing is as close to the right as possible, so I think about 7 would be good. On the other hand, for people who want to study fog, sunrises, sunsets, and other fluffy things, lower this number. This time it's a character, so I feel like 7 would be fine. Execution. These two automatically assign captions and tags. Yes, done. Please use this below. If you want to add it manually. I think it's okay not to use it. That data is LoRA's train data on the left. It's in the caption or text. Like this. Take a look at this. This is for those who want to be more particular. No, for those who say it's not that different, it would be nice if you could change this here. I don't need this tag. People who say this should be deleted. Well, even if you don't care about it. It's pretty accurate, so it's okay. Next 5. When I was talking about stable diffusion 1.5. Check this if you chose stable diffusion 2. I didn't choose it, so I'll just go with it. Put your project name here. Anything will be fine. Here is the model path. There is a model downloaded earlier here on the left. So this path. The VAE under it is the VAE path. Check this output to drive here. It will then be saved to your Google Drive. Okay. Is here and here. So here is as short as possible. Alphabets that may not have been trained as proper nouns. As short as possible, it is written as 3 letters. When it is official. Even if I say maso, I can't do anything with just 3 characters. I'm thinking of stopping at this length. Please don't put dogs or cats here. This class token is for learning. Like one cat. This time it's one girl. The rest is okay by default. Next is this. And this is a function that outputs a sample. That learning is progressing like this. For each epoch. I don't need it. People who want to use it should do it here. Choose a sampler. Here you can specify how many steps. And how many epochs to spit out samples. I don't need it, so uncheck it. Execution. I really don't understand this anymore. Here you choose what kind of network module to use. Up until now, it's been like this. This was the default. Network.LoRA has created these 2 new things. And there is also a story that this is relatively accurate. Because it learned things that LoRA could not learn so far. So I have no choice but to try various things. But this time I will go with this. I did this last time, so the difference is like this. What do you think? Do you know or don't you know? I feel like if you don't know the difference, it doesn't matter which one, because the way you learn little by little changes each time. So this time, if you go with this, it's fine without anything in particular here. The default that this was 128 until the last time. Officially, it's written as 4 and 1. And if it's a person, I think 4 and 1 would be fine. Let it learn with 4 and 1. And if you think this is no good, try increasing it with a multiple of 8. If it's just a person, I think 4 and 1 would be fine. So the bigger this number is, the size of one model file also increases. Since the number of GPUs to be used will increase, I would like you to consult with me about this machine spec. For the time being, try with 4 and 1, and if it doesn't work, increase it a little. I think that's fine, and the rest is okay by default. If you want to learn additional from previous learning, please paste the path here. Is the default after, run next here. This noise offset is 0. In the training config, set this to 0.1. So what are you doing here? It's like learning by changing the contrast a bit. Somehow it was written with such a nuance. Up to about 0.5, it's about giving a little reality. Without breaking what you're learning. Here's something bright about that description. It's an explanation that I'll do something good in the dark. But if you ask me if there's a big difference, I'd say there's not that much of a difference. So I'll just use 0.1 here. However, it is a little subtle, if you ask me if it is necessary. Second rate, this num epochs is the number of epochs to learn. Or whether to repeat learning. So the default is 10, but I think it should be around 30. Do this in later. You'll find a nice epoch that you like. I think it's good to keep only this. For example, you can save. The training batch size is a number divisible by the number of images to be learned. The larger this is, the more GPU RAM is used. For example, if this is set to 8, and an error occurs, an error will occur during training here. If you get an error, the batch size here is too big. So try changing to a smaller size. I will do it with 4 this time, but this is another save epoch type. How many epochs to save? I usually do it with 5. Save every in epochs is doing it at 5. After that, the default is okay. Next is where to get the file. to run with these settings, which is the basis of the start. Training. I want to use the file that has been set here so far. So here is the default. People who prepare their own should change this. This time it's the default. I want to use the file that has been set here so far, so leave it as it is. Execution. If this learning is completed successfully, the learned LoRA will be saved in the LoRA output of my drive on the left. In number 6, we test whether the learned LoRA is going well. Even if I use this, I still don't really understand the difference. So I'm trying to stop this and try it with the automatic web UI. Since it is already saved on the drive, this number 7 will not be used. If you want to upload to GitHub or something like that, execute number 8 of this. I don't do that, so I won't do this. That's all. It was a rough learning method. For those who don't understand the first in this series, if you watch the second part, I think you'll understand a little more. Farewell then.